Hey guys, what's up? Nick here once again, and I'm very excited. We're going to be doing a full unboxing and overview of the EK68 65% hot swappable mechanical keyboard made by EPOMAKER. So let's get right into it. Right off the bat, I do want to give a huge shout out to EPOMAKER for giving me this review device here for you guys to test out. This is actually not even available yet. It might be at the time of this video going live, but I will have a link in the description below if you want to go check it out on their website. It's going for $89.99 US. And honestly, for what you get with this keyboard, it is a steal in my opinion. Now, I'm not getting paid for this video. I'm not getting paid to say anything specific in this video. They just sent me this to test out for you guys. So if there is some things that I think need to be fixed, I will let them know. And if there's things I love, I will also, of course, let you guys know. So with the box here, it is a fully built mechanical keyboard. It doesn't come bare bones, so to speak, where you have to put all the keys in your own keycaps and everything together. It's all ready to go. So with all that, let's go around the box here. There's nothing too crazy to look about. We have a side profile there. On the back, it just tells you a little bit more about the EPOMAKER itself. Going to the product features, it is hot swappable, as I stated before, which essentially means you can put any switches you would like inside of it. 65% compact layout, multimedia knob control, RGB backlight. So yes, it does have RGB for all those crazy RGB fans out there, such as myself. Customizable software, as well as multi-mode wired wireless mechanical keyboard. So essentially it just means you can use this wired or wireless depending on your preference. So let's get this tab open here. Lift this bad boy up. Now this is the black and purple model with cherry switches. Now there is a black and gold model as well, and I believe just a black on their website. Definitely go check it out for their different color choices, but I do love the look of these keycaps. You can see there's a black all around the edges essentially, and then the nice purple in the middle. Let's lift the keyboard out itself, get that out of the way for right now, and we'll see what else is in the box in terms of accessories. So we do have a braided USB-C to USB-A cable, which is nice to see right off the bat. It's actually pretty long too. It looks like it could be about 6 feet. And then we do have a keycap remover and also a switch remover as well, if you would like to change out the switches that are already pre-installed. Looks like we have a different space bar. I'm wondering if the space bar has some type of design on it. And then some extra switches in case for some reason any of them are bad or end up breaking over time. And then we have the instruction manual, which is more of just a quick start guide, but cool to see that they do include some nice accessories in the box, ready to go. And we're gonna look at the main product here, the keyboard itself. And right away, it's a pretty light keyboard. So I've actually been daily driving the GMMK2 by Glorious, and this thing is a monster in terms of weight, scale, and it's the feature set. I absolutely love this thing. I did have to build it myself though. It came as a bare bones model and I bought the keys and the switches, everything separately. I had to put them, install it myself. And it was pretty fun doing that, but it was my first ever time putting a keyboard together. So it was a little nerve wracking, but all in all, I think it came out well. And I've been using this keyboard. As you can see, there's dust and stuff on it from the months and months of use, but I absolutely love it. It's a linear style key, so it's not clicky or anything. I've never been a huge fan of the clicky keys, but the thing that I'm noticing right off the bat with this keyboard compared to the EPOMAKER is the weight. So this is a pretty much like a solid steel build where this feels very light. It feels almost plastic. I would actually probably argue it is plastic. There's probably not a whole lot of metal in here, but that could be good for a lot of things, including durability, as well as being able to be portable without it being too heavy in a backpack. On the back here, we do have two sets of switches or stands, I should say. So we have the smaller stand and then the larger stand, depending on the height at which you would prefer to be typing. I'm more of a higher angle typer, so I'll probably leave it at the highest switch it can go to. And then as you can see, we do have the multimedia knobs for volumes, as well as you can click it in for muting or for doing specific actions. We do have two little LEDs down here. Looks like probably one for caps lock and then one for your battery life, which is pretty cool. And then we have the standard number key. Now there is no standard F key row and there is no number pad, of course. So this is a very small compact 65%. This is pretty much what most of the pro gamers are going towards, or just the gaming scene in general on PC. And rightfully so. You get a lot more room for your mouse, which is really cool. So you can get a lot more extra space on your desk pad. So you don't have to worry about that or your keyboard taking up much space. It does still have the arrow keys, which is nice to see that they are dedicated to their own buttons. And in terms of actual feel, wow, these feel really great. These are pre-lubed, I believe, out of the box. So you don't have to worry about going in and taking apart the switches and lubing them yourself. Obviously, you can still do that and mod it if you would like to change up the sound profile and, again, switch up the switches if you'd like to. But from out the get-go, and I think these are running with the EPOMAKER Flamingo switches. I could be wrong on that, but these are very linear. They're not clicky in any way. I will do a sound test, of course, in a minute here so you guys can hear that a lot more efficiently without having to hear it over my voice. But in terms of feel, I mean, these feel really good off the bat. I do like the sound as well. Sound profile feels really great. Stabilizers feel really good. Actually, it feels like a better stabilizer on the spacebar on this than on my GMMK2, which, by the way, the GMMK2, in terms of price, you're looking at about $400, like $400 to $500 max, where this, again, is $89.99. So just right now, first impressions, I'm very blown away by its presentation, its quality feel, the feeling of the keys, the sound profile, all very top-notch. The only thing that's a little bit giving me a little hesitancy is the weight. It just feels very light. But again, I think that's just for added portability because it is a wireless keyboard, which, by the way, not only is it wireless via the USB dongle, it is also wireless Bluetooth 5.0. So you can connect this to a smartphone or a tablet or a television, you name it. You don't have to use it on a gaming PC, which is super cool and very convenient. So, of course, going to the right side, we also have the USB-C, so you can use it wired, which is how I'm probably going to be using it. And then we do have, it looks like, a Mac and Windows switch. So if you do want to use it with a Mac, you can do that. And then we have a switch for the 2.4 gigahertz USB or for USB, which I'm assuming just means USB-C. And then, of course, the Bluetooth BT. So yeah, you have three different options for connectivity, which you'd never really see on keyboard, especially around this price range. And I'm assuming this is the dongle. Yeah, this is the wireless dongle USB. So pretty cool. It's also built in right there, so it's a nice little holder. Very cool. I really love the way that they set this up. It's just, again, it's obviously a high quality gaming keyboard, but like first glance, like boom, that's a gaming keyboard. But the fact that you could throw this in a backpack and bring it anywhere you want and being able to connect it to any device you need to, that's a huge step up and a huge feature for a lot of people. So good on you, EPOMAKER, for doing that. Really quick, I did want to check out these keys and these switches. So these keys, I believe they are double shot PBT. So they are the highest quality you can get right now. We'll get a couple close-ups of these too. So this is the purple key. So one thing to note is that this is painted on. So over time, this could fade. It's hard to say. And the RGB effects will not shine through the letters themselves. They will shine around these sides. But again, we'll plug it in a little bit and I'll get you guys a full view of the RGB effects. But it is a very high quality keycap. I don't think that's going to rub off anytime soon. It's going to take years and years of use. But again, that is something to take into consideration. Whereas if you look at keycaps like on the GMMK2, these are shine through keycaps. So they're not painted on. So the RGB effects can actually shine through the key and you can see that effect a lot easier at night, which I actually prefer. But the nice thing with these keyboards is you can always swap out the keys to any set you want. I can actually put those keycaps on here without any issues. These are just the ones that come with it, but these are excellent keycaps, great quality. I love the look of them too. The color just really pops, really nice. And then of course we do have these switches as well, which again, these are, I believe, the EPOMAKER Flamingos. If I get that wrong, I'll put it in the text below the video here, but we're just gonna use the tool that came along with it. We're just gonna pull one out. Easy as that. And there is the switch up close. Clear inside with the yellow switch itself. Two prong. Yeah, they feel very nice. They're definitely pre-lubed. Great to see. And we'll just put that right back in there. Clicks right into place, super simple. Put the keycap back on there, good to go. So yeah, hot swappable essentially is what that means. You don't have to worry about glue or taking off the entire chassis or anything like that to get to the backboard in order to get these switches out. Super easy, and you can swap them out at your leisure. And again, it comes with some extra ones in case, for some reason, if any of the switches don't work out of the box, you have some extras, which is awesome that they include that. So with that, let's get it plugged in and check it out for performance. I'm going to use my custom coiled cable that I've been using with my GMMK2 here, just because I like the look of the coil cables and I don't have to worry about actually getting underneath my desk to plug in the included cable they gave. All right, so we have the USB-C on top. We're just gonna plug that in real quick. And there we go. We're already getting some of those RGB effects going. Wow, that's gorgeous. And this is with bright, like, studio lighting on it right now. So this is a very bright RGB effect. I would argue it's brighter than the GMMK2. So yeah, awesome. So the only downside, like I stated before, with these PBT keycaps is they're not shine through. So the actual lighting will not come through the lettering itself. But with how bright this is, even with literally daylight lighting, I don't think this is going to be a problem being able to see it at night whatsoever. So this is clearly their like rainbow effect, which is pretty cool. But you can change it, I believe, on the fly. Let's look at their instruction manual to see if you can change any effects without having to actually download any software. So looking at the software, it looks like they do have different lighting effects. So use the function key and we'll try different ones. So function and Z. So this is what they called FPS gaming mode. Clearly it only highlights the WASD and the arrow keys, which is pretty cool. We have League of Legends gaming mode with FNX. So pretty much the entire left side of the keyboard. 37 key office RGB mode, which I'm assuming is the entire keyboard. Yep, there we go. So entire keyboard, essentially. Maybe turning off the top row for some reason. And then function and backslash. So this toggles through all the different effects. So there's a ton right off the bat. You don't even need to download any software. And there is software you can download, by the way. It's like a radio. Oh, it's like a pulsating. That is pretty cool. I'm gonna try to go through all these with you guys, but I don't want to make this a 40-minute video in RGB effects. So kind of like raindrop effect, and it changes color. This one, ooh, this is coming from the middle, kind of like going out. Very neat. Now, one thing I will say on camera, it actually looks like it's flickering a little bit, or like it's flashing, almost like raindrop going down. In person, that is not what I'm seeing at all. In person, it's doing a perfect flow effect from the middle. It's like this. So I know it's hard to say, like looking at it on camera like this, it's just the frame rate of the camera, but I can promise you in person, you don't see that at all. It looks like it's just a perfect flow out. This is probably the one I'm gonna leave it on. Very beautiful. This one's just kind of going all around. Very cool. Wow, there's a ton of effects. RGB to your heart's content. Look at that. It's like reactive, so no matter what you hit. Very cool. So yeah, the RGB effects clearly are a highlight of the keyboard itself, and I'm actually super surprised at how bright they are. Considering it is a wireless keyboard. So there's probably settings to change the dimness and brightness of the RGB effects as well for if you wanted to save it on battery life. Backlight speed, you can even adjust the speed of them too, which is pretty cool. So backlight speed, you can make it slower or faster depending on if it's like annoying you or whatnot, which is really nice. And then we do have different function settings for volume, mute, next track, play pause, previous track, screen brightness up and down, home, end. So even though it doesn't have the traditional F row, like we stated before, you can of course still get the F keys by using the function. So you hit function one for F1 and then so on and so forth. Same with if you want to use the print scan, it'd be function plus I, and then function O is scroll lock, function P is pause, home, end, you name it. So there's always gonna be different types of inputs to make up for the missing keys. So if you're worried about getting a 65% keyboard and you're missing out on the keys you're normally used to, it will take some getting used to use the function key in tandem with another one to essentially make up for those missing keys. But trust me, you'll get used to it super quickly. And the added benefit of all this extra space on your mouse pad is more than worth it. The last little thing I'll talk about is this knob here. It actually has some really nice feedback to it. I love the feeling of the resistance when you are turning it left or right. It's not a very smooth scroll, which I actually prefer. I like a little bit of a resistance to know exactly which notch I am turning the volume to. And then of course you can click in to mute or click out to unmute. And I believe if you download the software for this, you can set that to any button, so you can have it launch a program if you'd like, and anything of the sort, which is super convenient. And really quick before we move forward, let's get a sound test. So that essentially is my quick overview and first look at the EK68 by EPOMAKER. Absolutely loving it so far. I will be using this as my daily driver for the next few months, or maybe forever, you know, until I get another keyboard down the road. If you guys would like to see a full video review on this keyboard, I can go way more in depth with the features, all the RGB effects. I'll download their software, of course, and use that as well and show that on the video if you'd like. Just let me know in the comment section below if that'd be something you'd like to see. Otherwise, just leave me a question in the comment section and I will get back to you as soon as I can if there's any specific questions you have on the keyboard that I didn't address in this video. I know I didn't go over the wireless capabilities, but to be completely honest with you guys, I have yet to use a wireless device, a Bluetooth device, or a 2.4 gigahertz USB device in 2023 that has failed or had issues connecting or disconnecting. But I promise I will give you an update in the comment section below if I do notice anything weird like that when I do use this when I go traveling, or if I use it in the living room, for instance, maybe on my Steam Deck, I will let you guys know. But from first impressions from everything, if I was to sum it all up into one sentence, amazing build quality, feels really good in the hands, giggity. I love the quality of the keycaps, the switches feel really good, the pre-loop switches is a nice touch, as well as the actual input. It feels like it has really nice travel. Being able to type anything just feels really good. It's got a nice sound profile too. It's not clicky, but it has a nice tactile sound to it. It doesn't sound hollow is the best way to describe it, because it does have the internal absorption foam and pads and gasket mounts as well. And also I wanted to commend their stabilizers, because that was the biggest issue I had with the GMMK2. It's the stabilizers just weren't that great. But going to this, I mean, this is literally perfect. Probably the best stabilizers I have used on a custom keyboard to date. And you have the RGB effects. I mean, what else do you want in a gaming keyboard? So for $89.99, I gotta say this is an absolute steal. So thank you again so much to EPOMAKER for letting me test out the EK68 early for you guys. Show them some love in the comment section below. And also make sure to leave a like, share, support as always. Subscribe so you don't miss the next one. And we'll hopefully see you in the next one. Peace out. Hey guys, Nick here once again, and I just wanted to pop into the very end of the video to give a special shout out to my channel members. If you don't know what a channel member is, essentially, these wonderful people are using their hard-earned money to help keep the channel alive. So that's why I want to give a huge shout out to these guys, because they're amazing. And if you want to become a member yourself, you can do it as easily just by clicking that little join button below every single one of my uploads, or just by going to my channel. There is 4 different tiers depending on how much you would like to support each month, and you can join for as little as $2 a month. And trust me, even if it's $2, it helps a ton and it adds up at the end of the month so that I can get more games for you guys to review or make retrospective videos on, or to buy new technology such as new computer parts, or really anything to keep the channel afloat and to make more content for you guys. So with that, I want to thank Kenneth Fellows, Hull Healers Boatworks and Restoration, Wade Lady, Vinny Severman, and Thrasher to Black Stallion. You guys are all amazing, and thank you so much for all the wonderful support. This channel is just growing and growing every single day, and I can't wait to see where this channel leads us. So with that, have a wonderful day. We'll see you next time. Peace.